Hey, welcome back to Basically. On this channel, we simplify educational tech. I have found the most stunning app, okay? The all-in-one, all you need to teach online using this application. I'm super excited that ClassIn have sponsored this video. I'm doing a review of the application. Man, I have found a all-in-one application that does it all. Now, this is like Seesaw and Google Meet and Classroom all combined into one. If you don't take my word for it, carry on watching this tutorial and I'm gonna show you how good it is. Okay, good, excellent. So I'm gonna bring the dice. I'm gonna bring the dice here. Now, what you do is you download the ClassIn app. In fact, you can click on the first link in the description, okay, where you can go ahead and grab a free trial of ClassIn. And carry on watching the tutorial because you see how good it is. In fact, that's an affiliate link. I will get a bit of a kickback. Doesn't affect you in any way. It's free for you to click and get a free trial for it. I'm going to go ahead and show you what this app does. So once you've downloaded it, you'll get a secure login. You log in with your phone number and your password. So I'm gonna go ahead and log in and show you what's available. Now, what you do, you create an online class, okay? You create an online class and then you invite your students into the class. I'm gonna show you a demo of that. Hey guys, Guys, what we're gonna do, welcome to the lesson. What we're gonna do is we're gonna play a game, yeah? Snakes and Ladders. So let me actually bring you down here. I'm gonna let you play here. Okay. So look, we got counters. Tell me, Hafsa, what color counter do you want?
Purple.
Okay, pick it up and move it. See if you can move it.
Can I be blue?
You want to be blue, Steph? Okay, yeah, you can be blue. So let me bring you down here.
Oh, you mean
this one? Yeah, okay, good, excellent. Okay, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and bring a dice here, okay? And we can take turns to roll the die. Okay, and then we can move the counter.
Yay! Okay,
here you go.
Do we press the dice now?
So I'm gonna do a slot machine, see who's gonna go first, okay? So let's go ahead and press the slot machine.
How did you do that?
One second. Here we go, Yusuf. So Yusuf, you can start by rolling the die. Go ahead and roll the die, Yusuf.
I rolled it.
Oh, you got a 2, yeah? Okay, one second. Aha, yes, move. Excellent, excellent. So Hafsa, you rolled it. Now you got a 2, Yusuf, not a 3. You got a 2, you got to start. Oh look, you can go up. Yeah, you can go up. You're an 11 now. Excellent. Hey, I'm gonna give you a trophy. Well done. Ooh, you got a 6. Go on then, move your counter 6 places. Oh, you got 3, sorry.
Yeah,
and you have to answer the question. Chips. Okay, I'm gonna give you a trophy here. All right, good job. Not only is it live video feed like Google Meet, but it has a live whiteboard built into the application where all your students can interact at the same time. So you can set activities like a test or whatever, and students can annotate on the live blackboard at the same time. So synchronize, they can synchronously activate, you know, their annotations and feedback on the blackboard. Oh, I got 4, guys. So I'm gonna move mine, oops, sorry. I'm gonna move mine here, I got a 4. So let me move mine here. 4, it says, what rhymes with man? Van? So anyway, that was good. We'll finish off that game in a bit. We'll finish the game off in a bit. I'm gonna give Yusuf a second trophy because you were on the top, so you won that one. We'll come back to that, 1 second, guys. I'm gonna move your pictures here. And I just want you to write your name so you get used to some of the tools, okay? Can you write your name down, please, Yusuf? And Hafsa, write your names there. You can use a text box. Use a text box and then you can type it in. Or you can use your pen. Yeah, you can use your finger. You can use your finger. Here you go. Oh, well done. Awesome, guys. I love that. Okay, perfect. I'm going to move your name, your photos back up there. Here we go. Look, I'm going to put your card here. Yeah. And Hafsa, I'll move your one over here. What I want you to do is I want you to answer these questions for me quickly. You can write answers to them with your pen or you can type them up. It's up to you how you want to do it. Oh, excellent, Yusuf. Oh, good, good. Ooh. Oh, you're going to get a bonus point here. Well done. Yusuf, you want to finish it off? Oh, excellent. And one more and I'll give you... Excellent. Okay, I'll give you another trophy. You can give trophies to students, you can monitor students. What's brilliant, I did say in the intro that it sort of mimics Seesaw as well. What Seesaw is an offline sort of activity, task-based platform where teachers push activities and students do the activities offline, so asynchronous. This also does that. So for example, if I go to my class here, if I click my class, there's a chat feature. Let me go ahead and make this larger so you can see exactly what I'm talking about. There's a chat feature, there's a task feature. This is where I assign tasks to my students, okay? There's a test feature, and this is fantastic. This is like, I think, a Google Form sort of equivalent, or maybe even better, where you can set pre-assigned tasks. You can build a question bank. So the more you use it and you reuse it, the more rich the task bank becomes. Okay, so you can set, so these are tasks that I've set. Let's go ahead and assign a new task. I'm gonna show you what this looks like, okay? If I assign a new task here, what you'll see is, so if I give my task a title, let's just quickly give it a title, test task, okay? The current time, whatever. Let me go down, here we go, look. So the content of the task, so please enter the content. I could just say, please review the worksheet, review and complete the attached worksheet. Now, I was doing a class demo with, you know, grade 2, grade 3 children, okay? This works through K to 12 and everything in between, yeah? So let's go ahead and let me see what I can show you here. So I can add a photo, I could do a audio feed, I can add something from online drive, okay? So you can build up your resources on the drive with this application, so you can have everything, okay, on the cloud. You don't need to be stuck to this device here. I could actually use my cell phone. In fact, it has an app for an iOS and it has an app for Android as well. And earlier on, I was actually grading someone's work, a student's work, using my phone. So I was just sitting around using my phone. I was grading someone's work and I gave feedback off of my phone. Awesome job, Hafsa. Amazing job, 10 out of 10. Your adding and subtracting is perfect, spot on. So the beauty of this app is that you're not stuck to one device. You can use any device. It's cross-platform, whether it's Mac or PC or it's Android or iOS, you can use any device. I was grading using my Android device. The app is, the companion app is available. So let me go ahead and cancel this. You can add links, you can upload from your actual computer's drive. You can also use your camera as well. So on your digital device, your iPhone or your Android phone or your iPad, you can take pictures and add files as well that way. I'm just going to reset and add something here. So I can give instructions here and then I'll go ahead and press confirm. The other beauty here is they have a grading policy. So I can go ahead and use my own grading policy. I can out of 100 or out of 10 marks or order of merit. Okay, and I can go ahead and assign this. So I can build up a report card as well for my students, okay, that participate on my synchronous lessons as well as the asynchronous offline tasks. This truly is an all-in-one stop shop for everything teaching. Okay, so that's the tasks. There are tasks here. You'll see a few demos of the students completing the tasks, and I'll show you that in a bit. Also, there's testing. So I can create a test here. Now, I've created a few tests. This was a number test. If I go here, you can see that my students have, my kids have really, they've submitted their test, and I could go back and grade it. So look, I've actually corrected this already. Now from the tests, you can do multiple choice, you can do single answer, you can do true or false, and you can start building up a resource bank for all questions. So look at this one. This was sort of a single choice, 5 points. Here the student corrected answer, and here it automatically grades the tests as well. Because you select your answers, you predefine your correct answers, it would automatically grade the tests and give it a score. So here, look, the student answered D, and the correct answer was D. The student got 5 marks there. Oh my God, the more I get into the app, the more interesting it becomes. It really is. There's a lot here available for the app. This is just a short demo. I'm starting to play with it. I've got a few classes going. I've got a few students joining in. It is super fun. It's sort of ignited my spirit of creating new resources and using old resources as well. I can bring PDFs, okay, and PowerPoints, all the worksheets that I've got saved on my archive, I can import them into my drive here. So I can go to my drive and I can upload files into my drive, PDFs and the sort. So you've got everything basically. Don't take my word for it. There's a link in the description below. And if you click on that and download it for yourself, try it for yourself and see whether you like it or not. My God, the more I'm trying this, the more I'm loving it. It has everything for me to use for my online teaching. I'm currently using it for my kids at home as well. So I'm setting them tasks. So if I'm at school, if I'm at work, if I'm somewhere else, I can set them tasks, okay? And they can complete those tasks and I can keep a check on them. So it's working wonderfully for me. Give it a go for yourself. And as always, I'll catch you in the next one.